Within comics, it's actually surprisingly common to see two characters from different companies that bear a striking resemblance to each other. And today's face-off is one of the most widely talked about examples of this. Deadpool, the merc with the mouth, against Deathstroke the Terminator. I'll take a look at their weapons, training, and abilities to figure out which one would win in a head-to-head battle. This is Deadpool versus Deathstroke. If you enjoy this video, be sure to hit the subscribe button and click the bell to be notified when we upload fresh content. So before we get into the matchup, let's take a very basic look at who these characters are, starting with Deathstroke, since he was created first. Slade Wilson, aka Deathstroke, first appeared in 1980 in an issue of the New Teen Titans. He was so well received that he was given his own comic, which ran for around 65 issues. If you count the special issues like annuals and such. He would go on to serve as a villain to numerous different heroes, including freaking Batman, though he is easily best known as the main rival of the Teen Titans. On the flip side of things, we have Deadpool, aka Wade Wilson. Wait, Wade Wilson? Like, Slade Wilson? Nah. Crap. Deadpool's a ripoff of Deathstroke, isn't he? Yes and no. Deadpool was created by good old Rob Liefeld and Fabian Nicieza, first appearing in New Mutants number 98 back in 1991. Liefeld was a fan of the Teen Titans, and upon showing Nicieza his design for Deadpool, Nicieza pointed out his visual similarities to Deathstroke. After having quite a laugh about it, they decided to name the character Wade Wilson as a subtle nod to Deathstroke. Now, while Deadpool is often connected to the X-Men and its many spin-offs, he is technically not a mutant like the rest of that team is, as his powers were granted to him in a series of twisted experiments, which attempted to cure him of a life-threatening cancer by turning him into a flippin' super soldier. You know, like they do in Marvel Comics. They're always about that super soldier thing. Now that we have a basic grasp of who the characters are, let's jump into the analysis. What is a superhero or villain without some powers? Well, let's see, you've got Batman, the Joker, Iron Man. Okay, yeah, but here we're talking about two superpowered individuals, so let's take a look at their abilities and figure out who has the best. Also, just so that we're clear here, I'm only looking at their basic powers. I'm not gonna go into ones that they got temporarily or via some sort of cosmic event. So no matter how much you might want it to hear, Venom Pool doesn't count. For some, it might actually be surprising to learn that Deathstroke is in fact superpowered, as he is often portrayed as just a really kick-ass mercenary. But he was granted superhuman abilities via an experiment performed on him by the US military. These abilities include superhuman strength, speed, stamina, and heightened senses. He is said to be able to bench press about a ton as if it were nothing, and can use around 90% of his brain. Yes, I know that the whole we can only use 10% of our brain thing is complete malarkey, so for the sake of this video, we're just gonna go ahead and say that he's wicked smart. Is that better? Good. So in addition to being super fast and ridiculously strong, he is also a tactical genius, making a very formidable foe. On the flip side though, we have Deadpool. Deadpool isn't nearly as super strong or fast or even all that smart when you stop to think about it, but what he does have is an insanely accelerated healing factor. Every cell in his body can regenerate nearly instantaneously, allowing him to survive basically anything as long as one cell still lives. As such, Deadpool has been shot, stabbed, decapitated, incinerated, and even had his head completely pulverized by the Hulk. This power has also made him extremely resistant to basically every drug and toxin known to man, as well as being able to withstand a ton of psychic and telepathic powers, as his brain cells can just regenerate after an attack. And he can also break the fourth wall, using the knowledge that he is in fact a fictional character to his advantage. Whether or not it's a superpower is really up to you, but I had to mention it somewhere in this video, so there you go. So in terms of powers, the winner here is pretty easy to see, as while Deathstroke could literally tear him apart with his bare hands, Deadpool could basically just shrug it off and keep fighting. And while Deathstroke also has a healing factor of his own, it pales in comparison to Deadpool's, which is by far the most powerful regeneration in mainstream comics. So the point goes to Deadpool. Both of our combatants here are highly trained ex-military personnel, but which one has the better skills? Deathstroke is an expert martial artist and acrobat, able to skillfully execute even the most difficult movements and attacks due to his complete mastery over his physical body. His martial arts training has allowed him to stand toe-to-toe with some of the DC Universe's most skilled fighters, including Batman and the Bronze Tiger. He was even once able to take on 300 opponents at the same time and win. In addition to that, he is also proficient with all different kinds of gadgetry and modern mil-spec weaponry. A master marksman, Deathstroke is able to hit targets from up to 650 feet away with pretty much any kind of firearm you can imagine. And his military experience mixed with his genius level intellect makes him a capable leader and tactician, able to analyze an opponent's weaknesses and attack patterns to figure out a sound strategy to defeat them, outthinking them before they can even really realize what's going on. Deadpool is similarly trained in martial arts, having bested fighters such as Wolverine and Taskmaster in hand-to-hand combat. He is also highly skilled in assassination techniques such as infiltration and covert ops. So things are looking pretty even right now. However, there is one thing that I haven't mentioned yet that gives one of the combatants a slight edge. While Deathstroke could outsmart basically anyone, Deadpool's mental state often renders him completely unpredictable. Because of his multiple personalities, he often doesn't even know himself what he's gonna do next, making him incredibly hard to strategize against. This is how Deadpool was able to defeat Taskmaster, a mercenary who is able to copy anyone's fighting style on the fly. So if Deathstroke managed to devise a plan to beat the Merc with a mouth, it would almost immediately be rendered unusable by Deadpool switching up his attack pattern or doing something completely insane. So another point goes to Deadpool. Despite being skilled hand-to-hand fighters, Deadpool and Deathstroke aren't known for just punching people. So no fight between the two of them would be complete without some fancy weapons or gadgets. Deathstroke can often be seen carrying a few signature weapons, including various different varieties of firearms, a Scottish broadsword known as the Deathstroke, and an energy lance, which is capable of shooting high energy blasts as well as splitting into two separate Eskrima sticks for even more ass-kicking potential. In addition to his weaponry, he often wears a specialized bit of armor known as the Icon Suit, which is lined with volatile promethium, a sort of energy-absorbing metal that allows him to not only power his gadgets, but also take massive hits that would kill a normal man from the likes of heroes such as Superman himself. On the Marvel side of things, Deadpool often carries an assortment of weapons, including guns, grenades, missiles, daggers, tasers, and of course his iconic dual katanas. He's able to carry all of this because of his ability to pull basically anything out of nowhere as part of his fourth wall breaking. Unlike Deathstroke, however, Deadpool's suit is fairly unremarkable, being made of off-the-shelf materials by his best friend Weasel in order to hide the cancer scars that cover his entire body. And that about covers all of their basic equipment. Now, on a few occasions, both of them have had fancier tech, such as Deadpool having a teleportation device and Deathstroke wielding a yellow lantern ring. However, this is kind of their everyday run-of-the-mill loadout, so that's what I'm going off of. Equipment-wise, though, while Deadpool does have the advantage when it comes to weapons, due in large part to the sheer number of them that he can have on his person, Deathstroke's promethium armor gives him an edge here, as he'll be able to take pretty much anything Deadpool can throw at him, literally, as Deadpool sometimes carries throwing daggers. So the point here goes to Deathstroke. So with all the analysis done and all the points totaled, we now have a winner. With a total of 2-1, the winner of this versus face-off is Deadpool. Deathstroke may have superior training and equipment, but Deadpool's healing factor and unpredictability make him more than a worthy adversary in battle. It would certainly be a pretty hard-fought match that honestly could go either way depending on a number of factors that we can't really account for here. But just based off of what we talked about in this video here, I would say the safe bet would be to put your money on Deadpool. But that's just our take on it, and now we want to know who you think would win in a fight, Deadpool or Deathstroke. Be sure to let us know down in the comments below. Also, if you have any other ideas for matchups that we could do, be sure to let us know down there as well. Who knows, maybe your suggestion will be made into an upcoming video. And thanks for watching.